Welcome back to Vistamera online classes. My dears, as we all studied what is molecule, what is atom, what is matter and types of matter, states of matter, that is solid, liquid, gas and their properties in our previous class. Today we shall learn a very interesting topic, that is solubility of substance in water. Yes, my dears, solubility of substance in water, if we are studying this main concept, we should first know what is the meaning of solubility, what is solute, solvent and solution, which gives you complete information regarding solubility of substance in a water. Yes, what is solubility? First we shall learn now. What is solubility? Is property to dissolve in some other substance. Property to dissolve in some other substance. For example, if you are dissolving a little amount of milk in a water, it is capability of that water to dissolve something which is put in that. Is it right? Yes. If you are again taking a glass of water and putting some lime juice or some amount of salt, sugar in that, it is same capability of that water or that substance to mix some other substance in that. That property of substance is known as solubility. Next, we shall learn now what is solvent. Solvent is a substance in which gets dissolved. Solubility is substance which get dissolved. As we all discussed before, we have taken a glass of water and we have poured some amount of lime juice. And here we are having water. What we have discussed already is what is solubility. It means the property to dissolve in other substances. That is what we have discussed about solubility. But now when we are moving further to solubility, it is solute. What it means, that substance which get dissolved. Yet if you are adding some amount of lime or some amount of sugar, some amount of water, it get dissolved in the water. It means that it is solute. If you are mixing something in a water and which get dissolved is called as solute. Which called as solute. Next, what is solvent? Is substance in which solute get dissolved. I hope you have got little idea regarding what is solute. Now we shall learn what is solvent. Solvent means substance in which solute get dissolved. Solutes which get dissolved. If we are pouring some amount of lime juice or some amount of sugar or some amount of salt into water, what it happens is water is getting all the solute. Here we have already told that substance which get dissolved is called as solute. Here what is solvent? Is substance which makes that solute to get dissolved. That substance is called as solvent. That substance is called as solvent. Next to what is solubility, solute and solvent. Next topic is what is solution. Whenever we are mixing all these things, it means that solute and solvent, if they are mixed together, the obtained mixture or obtained product is called as solution. The obtained product, whenever we are mixing some amount of solute and solvent, is called as solution. That is what I have written here. Solution means solute plus solvents gives a product called solution. Now we shall go on with our next topic, that is solubility of water. As we all know that most of the things which are present around us, I am not saying all the things, but I am telling you most of the things which are available in our surroundings get mixed in water. Hence water is called as universal solvent. What water is called as? Water is called as universal solvent. Yes, my dears, I hope you have got little information regarding solubility of substances in water. as we are studying about the topic of states of matter, and there are three types of states of matter, that is solid, liquid and gas. We have discussed in our first class itself. Now it is time to learn or how these substances or these states of matter, that is solids, liquids and gases, get dissolved in water, as water is called as universal solvent. Why it is called as universal solvent is most of the substance get dissolved in the water. Hence these are called as universal solvent. If most of the substance is getting dissolved over in a water, our states of matter, that is solid, liquid and gas, must also get dissolved in water. Now by doing some experiments, we shall learn or how solids, liquids and gases dissolve in water. We have told you, this is water. What I have taken the materials to do my experiment is, this is salt, sugar, some amount of sand like oil, lemon and milk. As this is the main part of our experiment, that is, it is water, where water is called as, what do we call water as? Yes, water is called as universal solvent. Now we shall just go on mixing some amount of solids and some amount of liquids and some amount of gas in water to check the solubility of solids, liquids and gases in the water, that is generally called as universal solvent. Now I am going to take some amount of universal solvent, that is water, and now I am going to mix it with the salt. Where this is salt, see, if I am mixing it, I'm stirring this. See, the salt which I have poured in this liquid, that is universal solvent, water, has got dissolved over. Yes, my dears. Next, we shall see on adding sugar what it happens. Now I have added some amount of sugar into this beaker and just continuously stirring this. And I hope you are all very familiar with these things in our homes, and you can even see these experiments by doing it in your home. See, the amount of sugar which I have added in this has got dissolved over. By this we can tell that salt and sugars are getting dissolved over in a water. But here it is also, we are having some other liquid, some other solid, that is sand. Now just see, if we are adding some amount of sand to water, that is universal solvent, it is not getting dissolved over. The particles of the sand got settled down in the water. They have got settled down in the water. So we can tell that sand is not going to mix in water, but the things which I have used before, that is salt and sugar, are going to mix in water. As we have discussed in our class, that is solids, not all the things present in our surroundings get dissolved over in our water, but most of the things get dissolved in the water, as we are told. The examples for the things which get dissolved over in a water are like sugar and salt. The thing which do not get dissolved over in a water, which are in the form of solid or which are in the state like solids, that is sand. Next, we shall move on with our next things which I have taken here. See, here I have taken solids, all the things, and made my experiment. Now I am going to take some amount of liquids, that is I am going to add some amount of milk to this, where milk even got dissolved in the water. By this we can, there is no particles which are settled down in the beaker. So we can tell that water, milk which I have taken here, is getting dissolved in the water.
Next, when we are taking some amount of lime juice, as I told you, if I am going to add some amount of lime juice to this, where both of them are liquid in state. See, here lime juice have also got mixed over in a water or dissolved in a water. And whenever we are taking some amount of oil, as this is also liquid, na? See, I have taken some amount of oil. I am pouring some amount of oil. Here, we absorb the oil which I have poured is present here only, that is at the top of water which is not getting dissolved. So that as sand is the exceptional case which is not getting dissolved over in a water, here we have a oil as an exceptional case which is not getting dissolved over in a water. Next, we have studied solubility of solids and liquids. Now, all of you are very familiar with this drink, that is cold drink. This cold drink is not only consisting of water, here there is compression of gas which is also known as carbonated gas in this. Hence, whenever we are shaking, before opening the glass, we are seeing some amount of bubbles which shows the presence of gas in the liquid. Yes, my dears, we have studied the solubility of solids, liquids and gases. Now, I would like to give the chart regarding solubility of substance in a water, what we have studied with the examples. I hope you have noted down all the points which I have written on the board. Now, I am writing the differentiations or different examples which are getting dissolved or which are not getting dissolved. Here, states of matter. Next, soluble, insoluble. As we have studied what is soluble and insoluble, I have not mentioned anywhere the word insoluble, but I have shown you examples. Like the examples are like sand, which is not getting dissolved in the water. So we call that substance as insoluble. As oil, state of matter is first we shall study our solid. The soluble things which we have added in water are like salt, sugar. The insoluble substance we have added is salt. The next thing is liquid. The examples which get dissolved over or soluble in liquids are like lime water. And next thing is like milk. And the insoluble things are like oils or some ghee, whatever they are taking, the fatty acids or fatty things. Next, after solid liquid, we have studied about gases. The things which are, not only the thing which I have showed here is getting dissolved, carbonated water, but as we take oxygen which is present in our environment, how could aquatic animals live? As we all know that what are aquatic animals means, the animals which live underwater. How do they get oxygen? Yes, they get oxygen by the water which is already dissolved in the water. The oxygen is the thing which is already got dissolved over in the water. Yes, my dears, the soluble is like
oxygen and carbohydrates. Your homework is to find the insoluble things for gases, the things which are insoluble in gases. Sorry my dears, I have not observed here insoluble sand. Yes my dears, now in this class we have studied about solubility of water and solubility of solids, liquids and gases in the water, and I have also given the charts for the examples of solubility of solids, liquids and gases. Yes my dears, I hope this completes 90% of your chapter, and we have just left over with a small concept, and in our next class we shall study over with that concept and end of this class or end of this second chapter. Thank you.